Welcome guys. So today's video we are going to solve the Laplace transform of the signal damped sinusoidal waveform. Okay, you see x of t equal to e power minus a t sine omega t u of t. Okay, you see. So what are all the so the signal, the given signal x of t consists of e power minus a t. First, what is e power minus a t? It is an exponentially decaying signal. So we solved e power minus a t u of t problem separately. Okay, so you know the answer. So what is the Laplace transform of e power minus a t u of t? 1 divided by s plus a. Okay, and sine omega t u of t. So we solved sine omega t problem also. Okay, the sinusoidal signal in the previous video. So the Laplace transform of the sinusoidal signal is, it's a omega divided by s squared plus omega squared. And but in the given problem, so the x of t is nothing but the exponentially decaying signal multiplied with the sinusoidal signal. Okay, so that's why this signal, it is called as the damped sinusoidal signal. That is what is the meaning means. So you know the sine omega t u of t means the sine wave, it is having throughout the time, the sine wave is having the constant amplitude, a means a. Okay, but the sine wave is multiplied with e power minus a t means the shape is sine, but the amplitude of that wave is decaying one. Okay, so initially it is having the maximum value one, then after that when the time increases, the shape is sine wave, but the amplitude of that sinusoidal waveform is decreasing. It is said to be the exponentially decaying sinusoidal waveform. Okay, so we are going to find the Laplace transform of this one. Okay, so it's an important question. So it's a 8-mark question. It is as per the December 2013. Okay, so either e power minus a t sine omega t, then the another problem is that e power minus a t cos omega t. In the next video we will study that problem. Okay, so in order to solve that problem, first we have to write the Laplace transform formula. So what is the Laplace transform formula? X of s equal to integration x of t e power minus st dt. Okay, so in the next step we have to substitute the value of x of t. So here the x of t is e power minus a t sine omega t u of t. So you know this function, this multiplied function is multiplied with u of t. So you know u of t, if one signal u of t, it will come in, that signal is a causal signal. What is causal signal? This, that signal is appeared only for the positive time. So that's why the integration limit is minus infinity to infinity is restricted to 0 to infinity. Okay, so what is the x of t? E power minus a t sine omega t into, in the formula, e power minus s t dt is there. Okay, so here one sine term is there, two e power term is there. Okay, so you know in the calculation of sine omega t itself, the sine omega t, it can be expanded as e power, the sine theta equal to e power j theta minus e power minus j theta divided by 2j. Okay, so in the place of theta, which term is available? Omega t is available. Okay, so instead of this sine omega t, we can written as e power j omega t minus of e power minus j omega t divided by 2j. Okay, you can write. Then here this 1 by 2j is a constant, so you take it outside. Then you multiply this e power minus a t e power minus s t to both the term. So we can get first one, the e power minus a t e power j omega t e power minus s t dt. Okay, this is the first term. Then minus, okay, minus e power minus a t e power minus j omega t e power minus 3 s t into dt. Okay, so here there are 3 e power term is there. So the base is common, so you have to add the powers. So in the power, you just t as a common. Okay, you take minus t as a common. So we have to write, so you see e power, always when we are writing this e power, the first term, it should be s term. Okay, so e power minus the variable s. Okay, then in the a, the constant a, real part, then this imaginary part minus j omega. So if you are splitting this, this 3 e power mean, we will get this 3 answers. Okay, then minus of, similarly you just combine this 3 e powers, so we will get like this. Okay, then we have to integrate this part. So if you are integrating this, e power minus s plus a minus j omega t divided by the constant minus of s plus a minus j omega with the limit 0 to infinity. Similarly, minus, if you are integrating this, we will get like this. Okay. Then if you are substituting the upper limit, infinity means e power minus infinity, it is 0. Okay, minus of, when we are substituting the lower limit, we will get 1. So 1 by this one. Similarly, minus, when we are substituting the upper limit, 0. Minus of, when we are substituting the lower limit, we will get plus 1. Okay, 1 divided by this. And this minus of minus, it cancelled plus. Similarly, this minus of minus, plus. So after that, we will get the value 1 by 2j, 1 by s plus a minus j omega, minus 1 by s plus a plus j omega. Okay, so this is the answer for the Laplace transform of e power minus at into sine omega t. If it is a sine omega t, means the Laplace transform answer is 1 by 2j, 1 by s minus j omega minus 1 by s plus j omega. Here this a, it will not come. Okay, if it is a e power minus at, means this 2j term is not there, only 1 by s plus a. Okay, so here both the term is available. So then you take LCM for these two things. So after that, after cancelling, so we will get here 2j omega by this. So 2j, 2j cancelled. So what is the final answer? Omega by s plus a squared plus omega squared. So this is the answer for the Laplace transform of e power minus at sine omega t. So you know, sine omega t u of t, what is the Laplace transform? Omega by s squared plus omega squared. E power minus at means 1 by s plus e. So then we are combining the two thing, means we will get, in the place of s, we have to put s plus a. Okay, that's all. So this is the Laplace transform of e power minus at sine omega t. Okay, then next one, we have to obtain the ROC value. So in order to obtain the ROC value, first we have to obtain the poles. Okay, so in order to calculate the poles, so you take this part. Okay, this x of s, okay, that is before the LCM taken, you take this x of s equal to this one. So in this, this is one term and this is one term. So according to this term, which one is a pole? S plus a minus j omega equal to 0 means, so s equal to minus a plus j omega. So the first pole is minus a plus j omega. Now according to this term, the pole is minus a minus j omega. Okay, so these are all the two poles. Okay, so in the ROC diagram, first we have to mark the pole. So what is the first pole? The real value is minus a, the imaginary value is j omega. So you see, here the minus a, so the minus a is this part. Okay, this is the real axis, this is the imaginary axis. So minus a plus j omega, it will come here. Okay, you know, this is the minus a plus j omega. The imaginary part is positive term, the real part is minus. So this is the first pole. The second pole is minus a minus j omega. So here the pole P2 is available. Okay, so in the pole, we have to draw the boundary region. Okay, so what is this? What is the given signal? The given signal is a causal or anti-causal? Causal. Okay, so you know, the given signal is a causal signal, means the ROC region is always right-sided region. Okay, so the pole, this is the pole, means this is the boundary, means after this boundary only the ROC region is available. Okay, so let us see the ROC value. So how to calculate the ROC? So you know, here there are two terms there. So if the given signal consisting of two terms, means we have to find the ROC one, ROC two, then we have to combine the both ROCs. So according to the first statement, the ROC one is real of this denominator part, s plus a minus j omega is greater than 0. Okay, so real of s plus a minus j omega. So real means a is a real, minus j omega is a imaginary. So this imaginary term discarded. So according to this, real of s plus a greater than 0. So real of s, this plus a, it will coming to this side, means it will take as a minus a. So sigma greater than minus a. This is the ROC 1. Okay, and the ROC 2 is, you see, the second part. So real of s plus a plus j omega is greater than 0. So this j omega is imaginary, so you just discard. So real of s greater than minus a, that is sigma greater than minus a. So the both the ROCs are same only. Okay, so which region is ROC? This is the plus a. Okay, sigma greater than minus a region. This region is said to be the ROC. Okay, so this is the damped sinusoidal signal. Okay, damped sinusoidal signal e power minus a t sin omega t. So you know e power minus a t means 1 by s plus a. Sin omega t means omega by s square plus omega square. If you are combining the two thing means the sin answer, the sin structure answer will come, and in the place of s we have to put s plus a. Okay, so this signal is having the answer omega by s plus a the square plus omega square. Okay, so that's all. So study this problem, and in the next video we are going to solve the damped cosine signal problem. Okay, so keep watching my channel and subscribe my channel for more videos, and share this video to your friends. Thank you.